In this video, I'm going to show you 4 free SEO checkers that don't suck. I tested over 20 of them personally, so you don't have to. I actually used one of these SEO tools just the other day for an enterprise client of ours to identify a nasty canonicalization issue they had going on. Several of these tools I'm pretty confident that you probably haven't heard of, so let's dive in and check them out. We need a website to test these tools on. So I'm at Blues City Deli here in St. Louis. It is a bit of a sandwich institution locally. Don't believe me? Check out the reviews. They're pretty amazing. I eat it in the street, said this guy. It's so good, I like to watch people eat it, said another guy. Seriously, the reviews are amazing. The lines, there's always a line out the door. Don't let that discourage you if you're ever here. It moves fast. Check it out. This brings us to our first tool. I have put Blue City Deli into Moz Local. Now, this is a paid tool, but they have this free version that you can use, and it's pretty comprehensive. So Blue City Deli is in good shape overall. You can see they have a 78% score. They're looking pretty good. Now, what you'll notice is a few of these listings are incomplete. You can click on these and some of them will take you directly to the website to like fill out your listings. And what you're doing there is you're filling out NAP, name, address, phone number. That's a big thing in local for local businesses. You want a consistent name, address, and phone number in all the different networks and directories. And you want as many of these citations as possible. So Moz is highlighting where you have it right and where you're missing some of these, and you can click right through. And you don't have to get the paid tool or anything to do that. It'll send you right to them. Also shows you where some of your data is incomplete. Either these are missing, or here you have an opportunity to add 5 more photos and a bunch of more categories as well. But the key again is to make sure that your NAP is correct. Like if you had an address 2438 McNair, but they forgot Avenue, you want to clean that up. Now you can do it all manually, and this tool will help you point out where the issues are, or you can use the paid version and they will help you clean that up in a more automated fashion. That brings us to tool number 2. Tool number 2 is the SEO Toolbox from SEOsitecheckup.com. You get 1 free test per day, or you can sign up and get 15 free tests. I had already used my free test inadvertently, and rather than trying to become hacker man or something, and I figured flush my IP out, I just signed up, took like 3 seconds, and now I have 15 sites that I can analyze, like 15 free credits. You'll notice right away that they have highlighted that your meta description is missing. And while a meta description is not a direct ranking factor, it can be an indirect one. And what I mean by that is Google's just gonna make up the description if you don't have one there. It's just gonna guess what should be there. Well, I want you to control that message because you need to match your description to search intent and induce the click, make people click through at a higher rate. And so while it's not a direct factor, it's indirectly influencing if someone clicks through to your result on the SERP. So it's highly important in that sense. Also, you'll notice a lot of these tools go into keyword usage and things like that. That's a little bit tricky until you set it up perfectly because it may think that a keyword is important that isn't. So you have to take some of these results with a grain of salt. Let's look at some of the rest of these sitemap. So they're saying, okay, you're lacking a sitemap. And what I like is you can click on this, it tells you what to do. And so that's very helpful. It's not just, oh, okay, you don't have that. Here's how to fix it. I also like that it's testing the amount of objects on a page. So what that really is how many requests are happening. So you can see here, they have tons of scripts. We talked about that in the last video on WordPress optimization, how to get those scripts down and minified and combined CSS to like one file instead of 10 or 20. And that's what's slowing down their server. Also looks at the mobile snapshots. Very comprehensive. And like I said, 1 free per day, or you get 15 if you sign up for free with your email. SE Optima, and I think that stands for Search Engine Optimer, but if I'm butchering it, please someone correct me in the comments. I've run the same site, Blue City Deli, and what I like about this one is, to my knowledge, I've tried multiple times and I've never had it stop me and ask me to, you know, hey, you only get one. But I really like this visual chart down here, which shows the page speed info, and it's showing your server response and then your scripts, total page size. And just that visualization is kind of nice, like showing you the danger zone of what they consider good, a warning, and now where you're at. And so what I'm seeing as a pattern with all these tools is they're noticing that while Blue City Deli maybe has some of the optimization on page down, they have some of the local stuff mostly down, their website is not very speedy. And that's coming up in all of these. And so using multiple of these can be good because it kind of reinforces some of the issues. Like you see, they're saying, hey, minify your JavaScript. And we just saw they had like, you know, 25 JavaScript files. And so they need to minify them and combine them. This brings us to the last tool. So we're going to go back over to Blue City Deli website, and I have WuRing installed as a Chrome plugin. And that right there is an awesome feature because you can kind of take this around the web with you, click it anytime. You can see, again, they're all picking up very similar things. The meta description is an issue. If we go click on the mobile icon, we can see how the mobile rendering looks. And we can look again, look at where these errors are coming up over and over and over. It's load time, page speed, things like that. And so these tools are all kind of picking up on that. So these are the four tools that, for just a quick hit, hey, what's going on with these sites before maybe I take it into a paid tool and do a deep site scan and really get into the technicals. This just allows me a very fast way to do an SEO analysis with these checkers and come away with a pretty good idea of the direction we need to go when we're looking at auditing some of these technical issues. Let me know down in the comments which of these tools that you find the most useful. And I'll see you in the next video.